Okay, we made a tableau graph in the previous video with a list of the cities that start with the letter Z, but we didn't have the country names in there. And the reason why we didn't have the country names in there was because this table only has the two-letter country code abbreviation, the ISO. But I have a table here now. I've imported a table that gives you the full name for each two-letter ISO 9000 abbreviation, and so I've built a query here called cities and countries that links the country ID in World Cities Pop to the country ID in my ISO 9000 country code abbreviations, right? So it'll show you a list of the full country name for each city. And you notice also that some cities have no population. It's not that nobody lives there. It's just that they don't know what the population is. But that's kind of annoying. So let's filter out those records by saying is not null here. And there we have a list of the cities that do have a population, right? So that's the query, and it's called cities and countries. And now I'm going to read that in Tableau. So I'll fire up Tableau here. And I'll start it up. And we'll connect to Access. And we're going to use the same database that we did before. So it'll look at the tables and queries here. This is a query in Access, but as far as Tableau is concerned, it's a table, right? Access, Tableau doesn't know the difference between a query and a table. Now, year, it thinks that year is a number with a decimal point, but it's not. It's year is a field with only a whole number, right? And there's our population. It thinks the population is a string field. That's not correct, right? So let's change it to a whole number. Tableau will make stupid mistakes like that. It's not a perfect piece of software. So let's make a graph showing the country and the city, right? So I'll click on the icon for sheet 1. And here's the country name. So I'll put this at the top. There's a list of the countries, and here's a list of the cities, right? Now it's better if we make that the y-axis. So I'll just click on the icon to swap the axes, and there it is. And then we can stick, hopefully, the population into the data field, right? There's the population of each city, right? Zaranj has population 33,894. So that's a simple example of how to read an Access query that links two tables together. One last thing, we can change the name of that sheet there, so I can right-click on the sheet there at the bottom, and I'll change the name to countries and cities, so it kind of matches. I could do the same actually with the data source. See, this is the name of the data source, but you could change this. I'll just change it. I'll take out Global Superstore because that's not really relevant to our graph. And then when you go back to the sheet, there, the name of the data source has been changed there. So that's a simple example of reading an Access query in Tableau. Thanks for watching.